Well, anyways, let's speed through this. Yep, gets intense. Killing some innocent villagers there. Well, not really innocent, considering they oppressed Purple for a better part of the last, like, 30 minutes. Trying to go in with my cavalry, taking out the onager, and trying to take out his spears as well, because, or not his spears, his skirms, because skirms suck to fight. Skirms are like the most OP trash unit, because they have a bonus against the other popular trash unit, which is halberdiers. But yeah. So now he's coming forward right here, and this is something I didn't realize. Here's something I didn't really realize until later on, but there's actually a hill right here. So the reason that he's kind of killing me is because he owns that hill that's by this like little entrance. So yeah, I believe I build a forward soon. Yes, I kind of just brought my huge army that I was training over here up to fight here. And yeah, killing him with my light cav. So I know I said earlier that the Franks have really, really good cavalry. Well, not really, really good, but their bonus is better than what I had previously thought. See, they don't have bloodlines. They have husbandry, but they don't have bloodlines, which is 20 plus hit points. And I always read this as plus 20 hit points, not the percent part. So I kind of thought that they were basically just implying free bloodlines. And for a while I thought they should really make it say that, but they didn't. And so it's actually cavalry have 20% more hit points, which is actually really nice. I don't know. This guy has 60 HP. I know cavaliers are fantastic. My cavaliers had like 144 HP, which is pretty nice. And he's sieging my castle. What a damn shame. So obviously I take up the Trebs and fight them, right? Right? Come on, Luke, do it. Do it. Alright, nonetheless. Killing him with fire right here. Yeah. So it's just a battle for control of this point. Because if you could control this point, that's kind of like the first step into either of our bases. Like, this is pretty much my land right here. This land is my land. Alright, sorry about that cut. But yeah. So, yeah, this is his land over here. This is my land over here. And I don't know why I didn't really take Teal's base. I mean, I tried to get wood right here, but he has berserks right there, and I don't really want to mess with those, or at least get too close to them with my villagers. And so now I'm just spamming so many units to get into his base. And yeah. For some reason, killing red. And skirms against the pikes right there, because of course, again, they have a bonus against the spear line. And he is fighting downhill, but my halbs are just kind of meat shields. Like, my skirms are going to do the real work, and that's kind of where Orange failed with his micro. And oh, what's this right here? Oh yeah, he's probably focusing on this right here, because Purple is trying to invade this side and get his island back, reclaim his homeland. And yeah, it's just pure carnage out here. Look at the amount of skeletons on the ground. And then I bring in some cavalry, and they get stuck in the frickin' wall. That's okay. I move them into the base, and I start killing his villagers, yeah? Yeah, I do, okay. Good. Because if he doesn't have a lot of wood, or like, if he doesn't have a super duper amount of wood, he'll have a little bit hard time training continuous trash. And I'm glad I did this, because it drew his army over to here, so it kind of just allowed me to climb the hill. And now that I have the hill, I pretty much have this area in the bag. And so, you could effectively say that it's GG for this island, because I've pretty much won it right now, with a good diversion of cavalry. Oh my god, it's lagging my game, there's so many units on the map. But, got so many skirms, it's not even funny. Just straight skirms, and they're all on top of the hill, so anything that comes to kill them just dies instantly, which is pretty nice, and I'm still spamming them. I also think that I lost quite a few villagers in the bombardment of my base by red, which basically means that I have more population room. Actually, let me check. Oh, that's 44. That's what, okay, so that's about 100. Well, never mind. So, 100 plus... Well, actually, not 100. That's exactly 90 plus 6. So I have 96 villagers. A little bit less than normal. So I guess I didn't lose too many. But, yeah. And I'm trying to focus down his onagers because, man, that would suck. He'd kill so many skirms, and I don't want him to kill my skirms. And now I've claimed so much territory right here that I could just actually spam my units into a rally point that's actually in the base now. And so, now we have that. All his production buildings are going down, he can't really do anything about that. So now he only has these ones back here. And that's not really on par with the amount that he had over here, so... now he's effectively worse at producing his units defending this side. So, yes, there we go. And some more combat going on from purple over here. Purple's score is a little bit higher than mine, but maybe that's because he killed a lot of units, perhaps more than me. And I'm also trying to get my technologies so that way I can take a score lead and look scary and stuff. But yeah. And nice lag happening a little bit. Bringing the meat shields forward, so that way my skirms can take them out. Oh my goodness, the sheer amount of units lost. I really want to see the post game after this, because... Wow, that's gonna be fun. I bet Orange is gonna be in, like, the upwards of thousands of units lost. But yeah. Now, we're gonna see that I made a fatal mistake, even though I have taken this island, technically. Well, actually, you'll see in a minute. But I think you could guess by just seeing these villagers right here. So anyways. He's bringing out Siege and killed it. Was it worth my light cav? Well, I'd say so, because I have like 27,000 food, so it doesn't really even need to pay for itself. Paying for itself would just be killing the onager, so. Yep. And, yeah. So I've made pretty good ground right here. And in fact, maybe I would have been safe enough to just bring up my villagers to, build a forward base right here, so I don't have to walk them all from over here. And again, he does have an uphill advantage, but I have numbers. Like, I have mad numbers, wow. And yeah, he can't really do anything, at least at the rate he's producing them. He could start producing them from here, and yep, that's what he's doing. Okay, nice play, nice play. Purple has his island back, but he's not really training too many military. Oh, yep, he kind of is. He's kind of just attacking. And, yeah. Orange is saying that Purple made champions, and I don't doubt it. I guess he found gold somewhere. Don't know how. Maybe he was trading with Yellow. We won't know. I need water. Wow. Oh my god. Ridiculously long commentaries. Hurt my throat. This is probably like the first two-parter since, this is actually the first two-parter since the 1v7 I had. That game was like 4 hours. So was this game, but this was on 2 speed, that was on 1.5 speed. So that one might have actually been longer than this one. Eh, I don't know. But yeah. Nothing too interesting happening. I think it's safe to say that the only thing possible right now is a trash war. And, yeah. Although somehow, Orange has gold. Don't know how long he's had it. Let's actually check out his base and see if he has a monastery. Yes, he does, with 3 relics. Okay. Man, I wish I knew that. But, yeah. And sieging his other gate. He is getting prepared. And, yeah. My game is lagging, I can't even scroll with my right click. Gotta play on normal speed for it even to look okay. Alright. And the battle of this shallow begins. Now, champions are really good, and they really suck to lose, you know? So I don't know exactly why he's just kind of throwing them away. They're not even attacking me right now. And my light cavalry meat shields are just going to be a buffer, so that way I can shoot them down with my skirms. Bring more forward. Oh my goodness. It's a lot of units. And, yeah. So it's just all-out war right here. And, now I'm starting to get a little bit worried because my numbers are down quite a bit, and that's kind of what my foundation of my army was. And yeah, now he's kind of pushing back. So that's interesting. Ships from Orange trying to reach the skirms, but they're probably just going to die. Siege right here and whatnot. Getting back my numbers advantage, thankfully. And death. Oh no. Oh, I juked him though. I juked him. So now I've trapped him, sort of. He was following my halbs and skirms, and he got caught in my light cavalry, so maybe that was some accidental good micro, but I don't know. Yeah, nothing too interesting happening. What's going on right here? Oh yeah, just archery ranges that I didn't kill. Okay. Purple invading Orange. So Orange is doing actually really well. That's probably why his score is 50,000. He's probably killed so many of Purple in my units that he's managed to get a really high score from that. Because, well, no, never mind. My economy sucks, so. Okay. But, yeah, he's probably on par with Purple right here. Because Purple is. Oh, Purple! You cheating bastard. Wait, actually, he's not cheating, because I gave him that tip. Trade with the dead foes. Don't know why I didn't follow my own tip, but, you know. Oh well. So, taking out his production buildings that he built. And, well, why is he bringing rams over here? He's like regrouping right here, you know, and executing that poor green villager. But for some reason these 3 lived. I guess they got put in gulags by the Orange Menace, but oh well. Yeah. Taking out those buildings. Purple making nice progress, getting into the economy, killing everyone. And I've surpassed Purple in score. Why? I don't know. Maybe it's just my mass military production, but oh well. So yeah. Basically, the world right here looks like the apocalypse. There's skeletons on the ground, there's dirt everywhere, and yeah. Looks like a true war zone. And here we go. Bringing up the army. Purple was raging, I think. Oh yeah, he said eat it, orange. And then, orange is accusing him of having help from me. Which, I'm not gonna lie, he kinda did. And he won't calm down. I'm trying to tell everyone, not to be toxic. And, yeah, Exler has a good point. He didn't trash talk Purple when he destroyed the, island. Basically, this game loses a lot of fun when, people are mad. Maybe it's just because I'm a filthy casual, but oh well. Anyways. Yeah, bringing the army forward. Because you impressed me all game. Yep. And, oh, this is where it could have ended. It could have ended here. It really could have. But I've made mistakes in my life, and, well, one of them will become apparent soon, not just over here, but, elsewhere. Sieging the gate. And now I'm pretty confident that, Orange is pretty much dead, because when I come in here, his whole island, well, at least from what I can see of it, is gone. So, immediately, my first instinct is, well, let's kill Purple while he's here. Just go into straight anarchy mode. And, yeah, everyone dies. Except me, because Frank's Master Race Man. But yeah. Bringing the army in. Purple, he has to pull back because I'm killing him. And this was a flaw. I done screwed up everybody. He, like, by fighting Purple, I've effectively allowed him, I've allowed Orange to rebuild, because the entire attack was on by Purple. And honestly, I kinda just wanted to get into Orange's base and kill him, but when I found out that there was nothing to kill, like, from my fog of war, you could see that there's, like, nothing here, I'm like, okay, oh well. But Purple doesn't know how to stand ground his units, I guess, so he sort of helped in this flaw. And now the world will end. Complete anarchy everywhere. And yeah. So you see me looking back over there, and you'll see why. Respect to Elixir right there. I don't remember. Oh yeah, I was gonna do the hashtag thing. Let me look at the chat. Oh no, I can't. Never mind. It doesn't work in recorded games. It was something like, I don't know. I'll watch the recorded game again sometime. I don't know. But yeah. Now it's all out war between Purple and I, bringing the Habs forward, and they just kind of meet shields while my skirms kill everyone. Oh, but bringing it back. Don't know why. Oh well. Now, Orange has one villager, and some others somewhere. Right here, yes. I do catch this one. I catch that one. But my other fatal flaw is beyond that. And Purple and I switching score a bunch because, well, we're pretty much even in terms of military. And, yeah. Pretty much no micro right there. Because I know I win by numbers. And Purple, I think Purple knows my mistake. This is like some epic fantasy stuff right here. You'll see. I'll piece together the story when it happens. Well, actually, no, I already kind of explained it. By implying that Orange is allowed to rebuild now. So basically what happened was I turned on Purple after we teamed Orange, because I thought Orange was pretty much dead at this point. I wasn't sure why he didn't resign, but I assumed that he was just kind of, I don't know. I don't even know what I was thinking. But anyways, war never changes. Yeah. So taking out Purple's forward, and it, like, this is where the story happens. This is, I'm gonna write a novel about this, okay? So the blues invade the orange, and after successfully taking out the orange alongside Purple, blues turn on Purple. But little did they know, Orange was still allowed to rebuild. Now this is where I thought Orange was gonna resign, because he said that this was the best game all month. And yeah, I thought this was the best game all month too, because yeah, it's pretty fresh. Destroying his barracks, and he has units in it, but just a few halbs, so nothing too big. And out of water. Oh well. Oh, wait, no, I still have some left. Wait, that should get me through to the end. The end is nigh. The end is nigh. Nothing's really happening over here. But what's happening over here? A whole damn mill. Yeah, he's building a forward mill. It's getting aggressive, guys. And we all say GG even though no one resigns. But, oh well. Okay. Now, Yellow's score may say he's, like, doing the worst out of the survivors. But, remember his army? Yeah, he still hasn't moved that. And, whoa, holy shit, that's a lot of onagers. So, he's going to bring the apocalypse on everyone. I'm just kidding, I don't know that. But, anyways. But, I seriously don't know that. I drop out of the game sometime soon. It's probably... Yeah, town center, barracks right here. What's happening? We don't even know. Let's check out Exler's barracks. He legitimately has two. That's how close to death he was. Oh man. This is how I messed up everyone. Cause right now it's two barracks, but tomorrow it's 200. And so the invasion of Purple begins. I try to take out his one island, and yeah. Light unit spam into Orange's base. He is filling his transport ships with what? Siege rams and villagers. And nothing in that one. And he's building another town center. And yeah. This is why you need to scout everybody. Cause some shameful stuff happens. And as I kill Purple and train my reinforcements, it becomes apparent that I have fucked up. And I gotta stop talking about it because it's probably getting annoying at this point. But in short, champions. And Purple is building up his defense. He knows what I've done. He knows what I've done. Or if he doesn't now, he will know. Somehow there's more relics here, but oh well. Did he sneak in my base? Okay, good. I still have that one relic. I mean, I don't know why I picked it up. Well, why I didn't pick it up. Because if I did, I could probably get some sweet, sweet score. But, yeah. The invasion of Purple begins, and once more, this island that is pretty much the center of battle on the entire map, falls once again. And pretty much the game is boring at this point, so we're just gonna speed through stuff. He tries to defend, but again, I have my weapons mass production, I got everything. Farms everywhere, and well, we should see some spam soon. Yes. Aha, we're seeing it right here. Lots of heavy gold units. And so the flood comes out. I have gone back to my roots, and now that I've lost my entire army in Purple's base, I'm going to make my reinforcements. Let's just see how things look from my point of view. Well, unless he doesn't mobilize yet. I don't think he does. Okay. That's alright. It's alright. Oh yeah, this is where I catch this part right here. This little buffer of reinforcement. And that's not too hard to take out, especially with my numbers, but I wish I found this, because if I did, Orange would probably be GG. But yeah. Anyways. Yeah, Yellow's just saving up resources. He's trying to kill, Orange is trying to kill Yellow. Maybe I messed up there too, because Yellow would prove to be a formidable opponent. But, oh well. Destroying his production buildings. Hopefully ending the Orange Menace once and for all. But as we have seen time and time again, that is not the case. Look at all these barracks. Oh my goodness. Yeah, shit's about to get real. I wish I could speed up even faster. Oh wait, that's old. Okay. Yeah, it's a lot of champs. And, all that. Bringing up my tribs. My whole army is coming through. And I think he sees this. Because it's his wall right there. I think he sees that. I could have checked, but... He probably definitely sees that. Oh well. I also have these... He also has these nice little spots of line of sight. They're called farms, you know? And, yeah. I've lost my score lead to Purple. I'm about to lose it even more. Bring up the Trebs. Oh no, what's this? The whole army's coming in, and I see that because Trebs have a fantastic line of sight. You could scout with Trebs if you wanted to. They're just not that fast. And so the invasion begins. Or the return of Orange. Yeah. Does he move these guys out? He better. There's a lot of champions. I don't even know how he got that much gold. I don't believe that's from relics. How is that from relics? But anyways. I'm caught right here. Between Jaguar Warriors, Eagle Warriors, Champions. And what's coming out right here? More of them. And I can't mass produce fast enough to counter all of them. Or destroy all of them. So, yeah. My score lead has been reacquired once again, but as we have seen before, Purple and I are very close in score and stuff. Bringing out the trash army. And look at that. And I start flipping my shit right here. I'm like, champs, champs everywhere. Cause I don't know how, I don't even know what's happening. And I'm trying to bring my guys down to fight this, but I can't because I'm going to lose another treb. And I don't like losing my trebs because trebs are expensive. And yeah, it's just it's all going downhill. And at this point, I realize my mistake. Purple even points it out to me. He's like, hey, bro, you fucked up. And that's how it goes. That's just how it goes. And everyone dies. And yeah. Yeah. Oh my god, even more come in. Alright, this is where it happens, I think. I just gotta pay attention to the chat. Oh, I can speed this up a little bit. How the fuck? And then he's like, what? And I'm like, champs everywhere. He knows, man. He's gonna say it soon. Told you you shouldn't have attacked me. He didn't really tell me I shouldn't have attacked him. He just said, damn, Blue. And I killed his army. But it's okay, because he still has freaking trade somehow. Ah, god. It's probably my big mistake this game. I didn't have trade. But by him retreating right here, I kind of just take the hill. And at this point, I call the game. I give up because it's 3.5 hours in, and I have like a headache. I'm getting autism from this game. So at this point, I'm just like, no, I'm not a fan. And yeah. Plus, it's not like I could kill these champs anytime soon. Not without other gold-costing units. So at this point, that's a nope. It's a nope, boy. And I bet Orange probably won this game. If not Orange, then Yellow. But I don't know. I don't even know what Yellow did. He was probably AFK the whole time, just letting everything happen. He'd pay attention to the chat and stuff, but you know. Oh well. And reclaiming his homeland. Oh. He even says that, I think. Well, I know so, but you know. Yeah. That's it. Sorry the commentary's boring now, it's just shame. Well, I won right there, but I can't win everywhere else. Champions everywhere, man. It's the apocalypse, I swear. Flair. Oh yeah, that's is a nice little island resort there. And there's a castle. I don't even know how he got that stone. What? Okay, he has resource hacks. Calling it. But anyways, at this point I just give up. The attack against Orange is futile. I can't do anything against it. Yeah. This is my own damn fault for not trading with my dead foes. My economy is only like 2 TCs right now, and so I'm gonna run out of resources sooner or later. There's only so much wood on the map, and none of it is right there. It's all right over here. And yeah. So, oh well. Pikes being Nazis. I kind of thought Orange was attacking him, but this game is giving me autism. It's not even worth it anymore, so GG. I made sure to keep everyone on the water, though. And that's all we have, everyone. He starts coming forward, and I'm watching this part right here. Like, yeah, he's gonna kill me and stuff. But I neglected to get the rest of the recorded game, and there's not even a post-game there, is there? Okay. Well, whatever. Anyways, guys, thank you all for watching. Rate, comment, subscribe, and I will see you guys all later. Bye!